Hey guys, Renee and I are out here in the Appalachian Trail celebrating our 4-year anniversary, the best way we know how, hiking. And as we hiked, we thought, man, God is revealing himself in the most amazing ways to us, and he did so by relating himself and certain aspects of the Bible with our hiking gear. And the first one I thought of is, these are the hiking poles. These are the things that keep us balanced. It helps us keep balance from the left and to the right, and it goes before us and it goes behind us, and it keeps us from falling. But get this, even when we do fall, which I'll admit, Renee fell twice, I only fell once, but even when we do fall, the hiking pole is what gets us back up. And I thought, isn't this exactly what the Holy Spirit does? The Holy Spirit goes before us. It whispers in our ear, you know, maybe this isn't a good way to go. But even when we fall, the Holy Spirit encourages us to get back up, to keep going forward. What about our backpack? Now, you'll realize when you're hiking that you don't have room for luxury items. You can only bring what is absolutely necessary for your survival. So tent, clothes, food, and not crazy food, just the right amount of food for the days you're gonna be spending out here. Because as you're going uphill, you will soon realize, man, I really shouldn't have brought that. Downhill, yeah, sure, but when you're going uphill, that pack is gonna get really heavy. It's gonna be a burden to carry. And our backpack is just like our character. You see, our problem is sometimes we walk around this world with resentment, with unforgiveness, with anxiety, and with fear. And God is saying, take that off of your pack. It's holding you down. Only bring what is necessary. And the end of the day, when we go to heaven, we're only going to take our character, not our fancy degrees, not our fancy homes, our fancy cars. So why not unload all the things that are pulling us back in this life? And then, what about our map? Now, every so often, Renee looks at our map because he needs to make sure we're going in the right direction. But here's the thing. Sometimes the right way looks like the wrong way, and the wrong way looks like the right way. There was one particular instance where we had 3 ways to go, and they all looked worse and worse and worse. One place had a huge tree, the other place had rocks, and the other place was just water. And Renee said, wait, let me look at the map. This is what the Bible says. At times, the way that seems right to man is the way of death. And what is our map? Our map is the Bible, the Holy Bible. And sometimes in life we say, you know, I don't know what to do. But that's why, friends, God doesn't leave us room to doubt or to question. God says, just look at the Bible, look at your compass, look at your map. And through the Bible, we will know exactly where it is, because the map, the way the map leads us to our destiny, where we want to go, the Bible leads us to our destiny, heaven. And finally, friends, and this trail, man, we had uphills, we had downhills, and we even experienced a thunderstorm. And it's the opposite in life. Here, when we are in the downhills, we're like, praise God for the downhills. Everything seems a little lighter. But friends, when we go on the high uphills, this is when our characters are tested. It's hard. We're huffing, we're puffing, we're regretting some of the weight in our pack. And in life, sometimes, you know, we're going to have to face some uphill challenges. But just know that during the uphills, yes, it is hard, but our characters are being tested, our legs are getting strong, and that way we can enjoy the downhills. Friends, I pray that you will become a little bit closer to God, and know Renee and I are loving being out here in nature, and God has an awesome way of showing himself to us, even in our hiking equipment.